Good morning, everyone. Making blood agar media is an art. In microbiology, media stands a very important place for isolation, bacterial isolation of the cultures. So let me teach you all various kinds of media in my upcoming videos. But let's start with the universal medium, that is the blood agar. We are going to make a blood agar with 5% of human blood. And let us just see in the following procedure, step by step. It is a very simple procedure. Just you need some practice, some experience, and some pointers. Greetings, folks. So today I'm going to teach you all how to make blood agar in-house. Right here we have dehydrated powder of high media. It is a really good product. And for making blood agar, we need nutrient agar as a base. So the blood agar, the kind of blood agar we are making is bilayer with a lower base of nutrient agar, plain nutrient agar. And the upper layer will be nutrient agar mixed with blood. We are using human blood, 5%. So let me tell you first how to do the calculations. If you can see here, for 1000 ml distilled water, 28 grams is needed. Today we will make only 200 ml of agar. So these are the calculations particular. After you are done with your calculations, this is a measuring machine. So aluminium foil has been already kept on it. And now we are going to measure 5.6 powder. These are the flask in which we are going to put the agar for autoclaving. Don't forget to tear your measuring machines before adding the powder. Otherwise, you'll unnecessarily end up adding extra weight. Use a long spoon, mostly metallic spoon. For measuring of the powder. After measuring the agar correctly, it is poured in the measuring flask like this. Please take care that the agar powder doesn't fall outside the flask. So this flask that you can see particularly now, it is for the base nutrient agar. Now for the blood nutrient agar, we are going to make another measurement for the nutrient agar. After adding the required distilled water, this is how you should mix the agar powder. Care should be taken that none of these clumps that you can see now should be there before autoclaving. Otherwise, it will create air pockets. Now you can see how the powder clumps are properly mixed in the agar. If you think the clumps are not mixing, then you can heat it for some time so that the clumps are dissolved completely in the distilled water. But here, there was no need of heating because the powder is completely mixed. And you should shake it. Shaking is also very important. Now the preparation or draping of the flask. Here we are using non-absorbable cotton. The reason, because it should not absorb the steam which is produced in the autoclave. It is very important to cover it with aluminium foil. and the aluminium foil should be secured by tight knots. So as I said, we are going to use Nutrient Agar as base, and then on top of that, a layer of Nutrient Agar mixed with Blood Agar. It sounds a little complex, but let me show you how easy it is. And the reason why I am doing a bi-layer Blood Agar. So here we have the flask for the base, 200 ml distilled water mixed with the appropriate amount that we calculated of the powder. Similarly, in this flask, we are going to add blood, that is 5%. After this step of tying the knots and securing the flask properly, we will start the autoclave and try to sterilize these flasks. So now we have kept the flask for autoclave. Autoclave will be done for 15 minutes at 121 degrees Celsius with 15 Pascal as pressure. Once autoclaving is done, you can remove the flask after it has cooled down, that is the pressure has come down in the autoclave. I will prepare a separate video on how to start the autoclave or how does the autoclave work. That will be another video altogether. But only one thing I would like to see, after autoclaving your medias, you have to see that whether the chemical indicator that we have used, if you can see here, this is the chemical indicator strip that we have used here, it changes color if successful autoclave cycle has been performed. So it was green and now you can see that it has turned black in color. So now we know that whatever materials we autoclaved are sterilized completely. So you can see, now we can go ahead. For blood agar, we need to have glass petri dish. Can you please show me a glass petri dish? Yes, these are the glass petri dishes with the standard size. You need a glass petri dish, why, and not plastic medias like this? Because you need to appreciate, or you need to see the hemolysis, which is typical in a blood agar. So that is why if you use a clear glass plate like this, it is very easy to appreciate it against the light. If you use an opaque plastic media like that, it becomes really difficult for the identification of the hemolysis. So yes, so now going ahead with our preparation of blood agar, we have to prepare the base first. The base will be made 2 mm thickness. Why? Because 4 mm thickness is what a basic media height or depth should be. So now this is bilayer. So we will have 2 mm of nutrient agar base. Before going ahead, you need to check the temperature. So it is said in the books that 50 degrees Celsius is, you need to cool down your media to 50 degrees Celsius. But there are many laboratories which might not have a thermometer to measure the agar temperature. So a very simple method I'm going to teach you all is, once you let it cool down for a while, the media should be, I mean you should be able to just touch the media. If it is too much for you or too hot for you to touch, then you realize that it is more than 50 degrees Celsius. I mean, these are all just practical hints and practical experiences we get. It is not always that is written in the books. So if you have a thermometer, well and good. If you do not have a thermometer, this is the simplest practical solution you can use. Right now, it is convenient for us to touch the media. So So we can assume that it is less than 50 degrees Celsius. Let us go ahead with the pouring of the media. Just 2 mm. So even the marking is also not given on the petri dishes. If it is given, well and good. But if not, then you have to take your measurement once and then that should be used as a standardized measurement. So we have done a specific marking on the plates and that's how we know that it is 2 mm media, 2 mm depth. See how after pouring gently in each agar plate, the media is shaken again so to avoid any clumps. While pouring, care is to be taken that bubbles are not formed. If you can see here, there is no bubble formation which is happening. You do not want any hindrance in your media. After the plates have been poured, we have to wait for some time for the nutrient agar to settle down, to get solidified. And only after that we can add the second layer of the blood agar, the blood media that is. So to check whether your media has been solidified, you can tap on top. If you could see that while tapping, the media is not moving anymore. So it's been now 15 to 20 minutes that we have waited in the laminar flow, and now you can even nudge the plates a bit. On nudging, you can see that a little jelly type consistency can be noticed, but do not nudge too hard because otherwise that might disrupt the media. So this shows that we still have to wait for another 15-20 minutes or more till the media completely solidifies. So it's been almost half an hour that we have left for the nutrient agar base to solidify. Let us check with the tapping method. And now can you please nudge the plate? Yes, so now our plates have, our agar has been solidified and now it is ready for the second layer of blood agar to be poured. So you remember the second flask of nutrient agar that we had prepared? In this we are going to add the human blood. The human blood we are going to add here is from the EDTA tubes. It should be fresh 24 hour collected blood. More than that will not make a good blood agar media. And the most important part here is at what temperature blood should be added to the media. So if you remember just few minutes ago I had told you that you have to pour the media when the temperature is just right to touch. So blood is to be added to the media when the media is cool down enough so that the media is still liquid and it has not formed coagulum, that is gel form. Care should be taken that if it is too hot to touch or more than 50 degrees Celsius, you will end up having chocolate agar. A chocolate agar is formed when blood is added to the media at 70 degrees Celsius. It is definitely appropriate when you use a thermometer or a temperature gauge, but as I said, in some laboratories where the gauge or thermometer is not available, this is an easy method to see. Of course, it requires experience, but after that, it's a piece of cake. So now, the media is just cool enough for the blood to be poured in. Now, this is how you pour. If you can notice, no air bubble is formed here. The pouring action should be really smooth as of to not give any chance for the bubble formation. But if at all the bubble formation does happen, you can run it over by a burning flame and with a Bunsen burner. Don't give the media a chance to solidify. And if at all you don't have a Bunsen burner inside your laminar hood, you can just tap the media a little bit so that the bubble breaks. After about 1 hour, the plates have dried and you can check so that's completely solidification of blood agar. You can open the plates, you can open the sterile plates outside, you can open the plates if the laminar hood is on. Do not open the plates outside in normal temperature because it might have a chance of getting contaminated. So that is how we prepare a blood agar media. I hope you found it easy. And bilayer blood agar is actually much better than a monolayer blood agar. So there are some pointers I would also like to tell y'all. We realized that there were certain mistakes that happened. So how to avoid those mistakes? So when you write from the measurement of the dehydrated powder should be accurate enough. The measurements are already given, I mean the calculations are already given on the bottle itself. So you just need to calculate, the calculations are already given on the bottle, that is the instructions. You just have to calculate it properly and mix the appropriate amount of powder in distilled water. If you do not mix the appropriate powder, it might be either too liquid or too solid. The second mistake that happens is not to overexpose it to the liquid or to the distilled water. So as soon as the mixing of the powder is done in the distilled water and the breaking of the clumps is done, after just 5-10 minutes it should be in the autoclave. If you keep it for a longer time, do some other work, come back and autoclave and then do your pouring of media, that will give you in liquid consistency. That is because the powder absorbs a lot of moisture, and that is why no matter whatever you do after that, the agar doesn't solidify. And the third mistake that happens is usually when you allow the media to cool for a longer time. Remember when I said that if you don't have a thermometer and if it is, it should be just comfortable enough for you to touch, but it should still be hot at that time. If it is too comfortable or you think if it becomes lukewarm, that is when it starts solidifying, and then there's no point of the entire process because you won't be able to pour the media. So I hope the queries during a blood agar, and I hope keeping these pointers in mind and using the bilayer method, your agars turn out to be better than a monolayer. If you have any other doubts or any queries, or if you want to tell me anything, please write in the comment section and please do subscribe.